The desire to learn more about the cosmos and alien life is fascinating and has inspired a lot of scientific breakthroughs. One of these innovations is the creation of the James Webb Space Telescope that will be utilized for investigations and research on the origin and creation of life in space. The James Webb is set to revolutionize space research and has already begun to do so by the mind-blowing discovery of a possible civilization on Proxima B. And so, what do we know about the James Webb Telescope? And how powerful is the newly deployed telescope? Keep watching till the end to find out. The JWST is easily the most advanced telescope ever built by NASA since the organization began to produce telescopes. This telescope was recently launched to replace the previous, and now obsolete, Hubble Space Telescope. Since it was launched, we are beginning to see what stuff this telescope is made of. For starters, the James Webb Space Telescope is the newly built space telescope as earlier mentioned, and it would be used primarily for research about infrared astronomy. The U.S. National Aeronautics and Space Administration, or NASA, led the development of the telescope in collaboration with the European Space Agency, ESA, and the Canadian Space Agency, CSA. The JWST was launched on December 25, 2021, on an ESA Ariane 5 rocket from Kourou, French Guiana. The JWST is poised to replace the Hubble Space Telescope as NASA's flagship mission in astrophysics. Interestingly, you might ask why the telescope was named James E. Webb. The telescope was named after James Webb, who was the administrator of NASA from 1961 to 1968 during the Mercury, Gemini, and much of the Apollo programs. What makes the telescope so special? Well, the JWST has a greatly improved infrared resolution and sensitivity, and it is so powerful it can view objects in space that are too old and distant for Hubble. It was touted that it could view some objects up to 100 times fainter. These specifications imply that the telescope would be capable of carrying out several investigations across many fields, including astronomy and cosmology, such as observations of first stars and the formation of the first galaxies, as well as detailed atmospheric characterization of potentially habitable exoplanets. Interestingly, the JWST has a primary mirror, which is referred to as an optical telescope element, consisting of 18 hexagonal mirror segments made of gold-plated beryllium, which combine to create a 6.5-meter diameter mirror, compared to Hubble's 2.4 meters. This gives the Webb telescope a light-collecting area about 6.25 times as large as Hubble's. Webb's collecting area is 25.37 square meters compared to Hubble's 4.0. Unlike Hubble, which observes in the near-ultraviolet, visible, and near-infrared spectra, JWST will observe in a lower frequency range from long-wavelength visible light, red, through mid-infrared. The telescope must be kept extremely cold at about minus 223 degrees Celsius to observe faint signals in the infrared without interference from any other sources of warmth. It is deployed in a solar orbit near the Sun-Earth L2 Lagrange point, about 1.5 million kilometers from Earth, where its five-layer kite-shaped sun shield protects it from warming by the Sun, Earth, and Moon. But how does this telescope view the planet Proxima B? The planet Proxima B is part of the group of planets referred to as the exoplanets. Within the universe, there is a group of planets referred to as exoplanets, and they are a group of planets that are located outside our solar system. The universe is one big mighty space that is so wide, inside the universe are groups of solar systems consisting of giant stars with planets revolving around them. For example, our solar system consists of the Sun, which is the giant star with the planets including Earth revolving around it. These planets also revolve around their giant stars. The first exoplanet was detected in 1992, and more have since been detected. As of today, 4,906 exoplanets have been detected, with more still being detected. How are these planets discovered? Well, there are many methods of detecting exoplanets, but transit photometry and Doppler spectroscopy are the most effective, but these methods suffer from a clear observational bias favoring the detection of planets near the star. Thus, 85% of the exoplanets detected are inside the tidal locking zone. Of all the 4,000-plus exoplanets, the only ones that have intrigued scientists so far have been the Proxima B exoplanets. The planet has a recent discovery, which was discovered in 2016, located about 4 light-years away from the Earth. It is regarded as the closest exoplanet to the Earth. Proxima b is a super Earth exoplanet that orbits an M-type star. Its mass is 1.27 Earths. It takes 11.2 days to complete one orbit of its star, and it is 0.0485 astronomical units from its star. The planet has intrigued scientists because of its features. Many scientists within the NASA community strongly believe that the planet has a high tendency for hosting extraterrestrial life due to its position in the star's habitable zone. Whether it is habitable is a complete function of several unknown properties, such as whether it has an atmosphere. Proxima Centauri is a flare with intense emission of electromagnetic radiation that could rip an atmosphere off the planet. The planet's proximity to Earth offers an opportunity for robotic space exploration, for example, with the breakthrough Starshot project. But because of how far the planet is from us, there is no way we can tell if this planet could support life, and this is where the James Webb Telescope would come into play. The 21-foot foldable telescope is humanity's latest eye in space. In the case of the JWST, the vibrant, newly built telescope would help scientists understand the puzzling questions of how we got here and if there are alien lives out there. It would examine our universe from the angle of molecules, stars, galaxies, black holes, and planets that populate the universe. From these studies, ingredients necessary for life could easily be established. The results would help us determine the feasibility of life outside space. To search for answers, JWST will observe hundreds, maybe thousands of exoplanets before its mission is done. It will stare at hellish lava worlds with molten surfaces that whip around their stars in mere hours. It will study worlds that somehow survive the violent deaths of their stars and now orbit their leftover stellar corpses. It will gaze through the atmosphere of gas giant planets, search for newborn worlds among the dusty disks that cling to infant stars, and squint at a handful of small rocky worlds that just might be similar to Earth. One of the features that scientists hope to harness is the remarkable power of the James Webb Telescope to detect artificial light. LED lights may be detectable from Earth with the powerful James Webb Telescope. The James Webb Space Telescope will have a wider spectrum view than its predecessor, Hubble, and operate further out from the Earth at a solar orbit 930,000 miles from the Earth. It would be able to see deep into the universe. James Webb would be able to detect the narrowband light that is reminiscent of LED bulbs, which in turn would be able to characterize the atmosphere of the planet. Doing so will allow researchers to use instruments on the observatory to detect how much energy transport occurs on the planet and then perform calculations of light curves to determine whether they match those of an LED light source. Researchers believe if we are going to finally crack the puzzle of life in space, the detection of artificial light, especially in Proxima b, could be pivotal. Already, scientists have reasons to believe life could exist there, as the planet has the following characteristics. Composition. It is rocky and a similar size to Earth. Temperature. It lies in the habitable zone of its star, which means there could be liquid water on its surface, a key ingredient for alien life. The temperature on the surface of the planet could be between minus 90 and 30 degrees Celsius. Atmosphere. If Proxima b has an atmosphere, the simple ingredients, water, carbon dioxide, and rock, that are needed for the formation of biochemical cycles that we call life, could all be present and interacting on the planet's surface. But the problem is, Proxima b is tidally locked, and as it has a permanent day and night side, if there were to be any civilization over there, they may have to illuminate the night side using mirrors launched into orbit or placed at strategic points. In that case, the light shining onto the permanent night side should be extremely powerful, and thus more likely to be detected with the JWST. But what about the inhabitants of Proxima b? By far the most asked question so far has revolved around inquiries of what would proceed if we got to Proxima b and stumbled across an already thriving civilization. While we can never know for sure if they would be friendly or hostile until we get there, we can make educated assumptions on how they would live their daily lives and carry out daily activities. For starters, Proxima b, as we stated earlier, is tidally locked, meaning one half of the planet permanently experiences daytime and the inhabitants of the other half experience permanent nighttime. Assuming these inhabitants were similar to us humans and that they have eyeballs, or at least organs that provide them with sight, local inhabitants of each side of the planet would possess differing anatomies to better suit their environments. When exposed to excessive or continuous light, our pupils constrict to allow just the needed amount of light to see properly, Vice versa, when we find ourselves in a dark room or in dim lighting, our pupils dilate to allow as much light as possible so we can see clearly. That's why when you turn off the lights in your room, you might not be able to see anything for the first 10 to 20 seconds, but after your eye adjusts, you can see enough to at least navigate through your dark room. Inhabitants of the dark side of Proxima b would be more light sensitive than the inhabitants of the sunny side. And at the same time, the anatomy of the inhabitants of the sunny side of Proxima b would have adapted to their environment in such a way that they would need a lot of light to see regularly. As such, if anyone would like to travel to a different side of the planet, they might have to pack gear which is suited to helping them adapt in that environment. Directly tied to the issue of sunlight would also be temperature. The darker side of Proxima b would be colder because of the lack of warmth brought by their star. As such, those who dwell in the darker side would have also adapted into having thicker skin to better adapt to the cold. Concurrently, those on the sunny side might have a different bodily anatomy altogether, which may involve them having to constantly stay hydrated every few minutes. Their plants on each side of the planets would also vary greatly. Just as how there are plants on Earth which need little to no sunlight to grow, plants on the dark side of Proxima b would have already adapted to the light requirements. Plants on the sunny side might still exhibit phototropism, which is the growth and response of a plant towards light. As such, plants on the sunny side would most likely be tall, growing towards their own sun, while the plants on the darker side might grow in all kinds of creepy and unrealistic ways. Taking that they do not get any nutrition from their sun, they might have adapted into finding a different alternative to obtaining their nutrients. Honestly, we might not have to wait to meet the dwellers of Proxima b before we start communicating with them. If they are an intelligent civilization, they could relay messages that we could see using the JWST, and if so, communications between both our civilizations could commence. Before long, talks of finding a means to travel to each other's planets would ensue.